Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this pre-delivery session. Myself, Balaji Tandle, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I am here to present a pre-delivery session on a subject called as Kinematics of Machinery. So basically, Kinematics of Machinery is the branch of theory of machine, which is divided into two parts, one as KOM, another one as DOM. So KOM stands for Kinematics of Machinery, whereas DOM stands for Dynamics of Machinery. So basically, first we want to know what is the basic difference between KOM and DOM, whereas DOM is the Dynamics of Machinery. So basically, these two are the branch of theory of machine which deals with the relative motion existing between the machine parts. Now, what is the basic difference between KOM and DOM? Now, this is a branch of theory of machine which deals with the relative motion existing between the various machine members, right? And here we do not consider the forces which are actually responsible for causing the motion. That means this is a branch of theory of machine where our focus is exclusively, we are keeping on the study of motion. Like, motions can exist in the form of displacement, motion can exist in the form of velocity, motion can exist in the form of acceleration. So as we know that none of the motion can exist by itself, so for the motion to be exist, there must be some external force or external agent must act on it. So here, in the study of a relative motion between the various linkages, we are ignoring or we are not considering the forces which are actually responsible for carrying the motion. So the motion which is carried by the application of force, that is what we are not considering. We are ignoring the presence of forces here. And the study, such a study or that study is called as a kinematics of motion. That means our focus of study is purely depends upon the velocity, displacement and acceleration. Acceleration, it may be retardation also. So our basic focus is on a motion. Whereas here, in this particular, the second part of this, which is, we call it as a DOM, which is stands for Dynamics of Machinery. Here, along with the relative motion, we also include, also we consider the forces. So here, the forces which are responsible for carrying the motion will also include. And that study is what we call it as the Dynamics of Machinery. Now, before I proceed further, I just want to tell you the prerequisite. As it is the subject introduced in the second semester, so the student who are coming and learning this subject, right, they must know, they must aware about some prerequisite. In order to understand this subject, the student must be aware about the basic physics or basic science, and he must be having a basics, very very clear basics about the about the mechanics, engineering mechanics, and the student must know a very good engineering drawing. So the prerequisite is engineering mechanics, in short we call it as EM, then engineering graphics he should know, and obviously science, or it is called as, in other terms it is called as physics. So the basic physics he must know, because the subjects in this subject, the topics or the units which are introduced, they are all dealing with some of the basics of mechanics, they are dealing with some of the basics of the physics. If the student is aware about these prerequisition, then he or she can understand the concept present in this particular unit very clearly. Moving ahead, so in this unit, so this is first unit, which is introduction to the kinematics. So here these are the syllabus, this is the syllabus which we are going to study in this particular unit number 1. So as you know that the topics which we are going to cover in this particular unit number 1, which is an introduction to the kinematics, is we need to understand what is difference or what is mean by a link, what is mean by elements, then what forms the kinematic pay, then degrees of freedom, Graveler's criteria. Here we are dealing only with the criteria without derivation. Then what is mean by a kinematic chain, what is mean by a mechanism, what is mean by a structure, and very important aspect is mobility of the mechanism and its inversion. So the first part of the unit number 1 is dealing with the basic introduction only. An in-depth study will be made by once we are very much clear about the basic terms. So before we proceed, in order to understand the details about the kinematic chain, what is inversion and the various inversions of the kinematic chain, in that we have different types, like 4 bar is the one of the kinematic chain, single sided crank chain mechanism is the another mechanism, one more is the double sided crank mechanism. So these are all the part of kinematic chain or kinematic mechanisms. So before we understand these in detail, we must understand what is the basic terms which are important in order to grab the in-depth knowledge about the various inversions. So moving ahead, so before I proceed, right, so before we go, so let us understand basic definitions about the kinematics. So as I said you, kinematics of machinery is exclusively a subject which is dealing with the relative motion existing between the various mechanisms or various machines. So before we go further, we must know very well, clear, distinguish difference between the machine and the mechanism. So to understand this concept very better, let us take an example of our day-to-day life elements which we every day interact with our day-to-day life. So the best example to understand what is machine and what is mechanism, let us take two examples. The very first example is what I am taking as a steering mechanism. As you all are aware that everybody is drawing a vehicle, it may be a two-wheeler or it may be a four-wheeler. So we have a steering gear mechanism or steering mechanism, right? We say it is a steering mechanism, we never say it as a steering machine, right? So why we don't say this, why we don't call it as a machine, why we call it as a mechanism? And when we say the given mechanism as a machine, so to identify the basic difference, let us first understand what is mechanism. Once we understood what is the mechanism, then later on we'll understand what is machine. Now see here, the basic difference between the machine and the mechanism is that, so first we'll understand what is mechanism. So mechanism is a combination of a various members or a links. As we know that mechanism is consisting of a number of links or number of elements which are connected together in such a way that there is a relative motion exists between them, right? So simple, it is very simple. Mechanism is nothing but the combination of linkages or elements, right? When we connect them, say for example, I'll take an example here. Four bar mechanism, we say generally, consider this is the link number 1, this is the link number 2, this is the link number 3, this is the link number 4, and they are connected together at this particular 4 point, that is A, B, C and D. What is ABCD? ABCD is the joint where the link 1 and 2 are connected at this particular point, that is the joint at A. Link 2 and link 3 are connected at the point B. Link 3 and 4 are connected at the point C, and link 1 and 4 are connected at the point E. So this is a mechanism. What is mechanism? It is the combination of links. So how many links we have here? We have number of links as 4. And how many pairs we have? The number of pairs are also equals to 4. So the 4 links, when they are connected together, forming a pair at A, B, C, D, it is forming a mechanism. Right. Now, this mechanism is incomplete unless otherwise it is responsible for providing some sort of motion. Now say for example, as we know that motion does not exist by itself. So for any body, if it is to be in a motion or it is to be in a continuation of motion, there must be some external force must be given to that. So for example, if I apply a force on this link number 2, then what is going to happen? The whole mechanism is going to move. But my intention is not that. So I just want to get a relative motion between the various links. Such a way that if I apply a force to this, then the link number applied to the link number 2, the force is given to the link number 2, then link 3 and link 4 must be moving relative to the link number 2. So in order to do so, so the mechanism, in the given mechanism, one of the link must be a fixed link. And that is what we are going to do by fixing one of the link. So here, we are going to fix a link number 1, or you can fix any of the link. It's not compulsory.